Kia ora and welcome to CIO Leadership Live New Zealand. I'm your host, Cathy O'Sullivan, editor for CIO New Zealand. And my guest today is Kenny Hien, Chief Information Officer at Restaurant Brands. Hello, Kenny. How are you doing today?
Hey, Cathy. How are you doing? Thank you. Thank you for having me on.
Oh, it's a pleasure. So to kick things off, can you tell us a little bit more about Restaurant Brands and what your team there does?
Absolutely. I suppose what people don't typically know about Restaurant Brands is that obviously we run KFC, everyone knows that. But we also run Pizza Hut, Carl's Jr. and Taco Bell. And most people kind of think New Zealand is, we're based in New Zealand, we just do KFC. But we're actually a $1.1 billion sales company. We have stores in Australia, Hawaii, Guam, California. And we have about 11,000 staff strong. With over 460 stores, and we serve about 54 million customers globally. So we're a little bit of a mixed bag, and we're here to serve our customers. So we're super excited about that.
Yum, delicious. Talking about all these brands. So obviously, a huge part of your role is change and driving through, new projects. And we talk about transformation often as, it's a given within organizations, but in reality, it's not an easy thing to do. So how has that approach taken shape in your own career?
Absolutely. I suppose from my perspective, it's always been putting context to the organization and the requirements that need for it to be changed. And for us here in Restaurant Brands, it's the ever-changing customer journey and always trying to meet the industry needs, because obviously with supply chain issues, with staff shortages, with hardware runouts, we are continually have to evolve how we run. So for us, I picked kind of three key pillars of transformation. One being ways of working, second one is a modernization strategy, and thirdly is an automation phase. So I suppose, for the ways of working, it's super important that we have to create a model that we can scale quickly to meet the customer needs, because our customer needs are changing every other week, from closing drive-throughs to transitioning to digital to going to click and collect, and then trying to meet all the COVID mandates as well through all this time. So it's very exciting on having an operating model that can help scale those businesses. So the ways of working is really good in the sense that we have to be agile and think outside the box, and not anything's a problem. And then I suppose secondly is the rationalization, and I suppose focusing on some of key partnerships is, I think, it's really important in the ways of working. Because you can't do things alone. You're not an island. We have to find really strong partnerships. And that's, again, right back to the ways of working, super important for us. And then modernization with our infrastructure. Always continually upgrading all the old equipment, standardizing across our fleet. And also, again, looking for partners that can deliver us the agile and product services that we need. And lastly, moving on to automation. So, things like data and analytics platforms, predictive ordering and things like that. So it's all part of the journey that we're starting on. And then obviously all the standard CIO technology projects that you have, hybrid cloud migrations, data warehouse migrations, and sort of just a continual stream of work that comes from technology teams. Very exciting.
Very exciting and, of course, very, very challenging at times. So are there any kind of common roadblocks that you've encountered that, looking back on, just they're ones that you should be conscious of and try and avoid along the way in any transformation journey?
Yeah, I suppose for the roadblocks, a lot of it is trying to find that sweet spot between initiatives, change, while keeping all the stakeholders happy. So I think meeting all their needs, I think that's always been the hardest part for any role of senior leadership. But for me, as cheesy as it sounds, it's kind of like it's not a roadblock if you know it's coming. So I'm a meticulous planner and scenario runner. So I'll typically have three or four plans and maybe three or four mitigation tactics along the way to help us through those roadblocks. And that just comes with experience of just seeing it and being done it and having those roadblocks in the first place, and then continually evolving your model to kind of get around those, really, in some ways.
So I'm curious then, Kenny, how do you view transformation? Do you think it's just a project within a business with deadline and milestones, or do you see transformation as just an ongoing development in any organization?
I just kind of just see it as a journey, like the most other technologists. It's never an end game. It is just continually meeting customer and industry needs. But it's about creating an agile enough model to respond. So whether it be via partnerships or via technology sets or loosely coupled products, it's about having a framework to understand the scale and ever-changing landscape. So no, it's not an end date. It's just putting all the building blocks in place so you can scale faster, better, later.
Absolutely. So then as CIO, in what ways do you collaborate and influence the organization and its leadership team?
For me, a lot of it is just kind of like model the behavior you want, really. I think that's a lot of part of the journey. It's just showing an art of possible. I think that's really important. Like most teams are quite entrenched, and I think a lot of us, for us, it's just an evolution. So it's just continually growing us, model the behavior that you want, but also be ready to adapt. I think that's an adapt while trying to keep your core values and outcomes in mind. I think that's really important. And they should see that, right? And it's about just proving results and just and being there for them and saying we're all in the same boat. And we're all swimming together. I think that's really important for us.
Absolutely. And you know, the role of CIO, it is evolving. You know, there's a lot more terms now used for CIO, you know, a lot more chief digital officer roles, chief technology officer roles are changing as well. We've got a lot of chief innovation officers. So what do you think are some of the key attributes of a modern day CIO when it comes to leadership?
Oh, wow. Where do I start? You're absolutely right. It is absolutely multifaceted. So it's just like you have to be all those things and more. So you have to understand macroeconomics, local economics, supply chain, politics, regulations, new cyber vectors. For us, it's just about being all the words you would hear, being very curious. Lifelong learner, all this kind of stuff is super important for us to ensure that we are ahead of the curve. But I would say my kind of top three in the current market and the current infrastructure and the current setting, I think number one is probably having quite a VC mentality in the sense that you're thinking like a startup, but you need to operate like an enterprise. So I think it's just, you know, you just have to evolve with the trends, and then you also have to understand how to monetize it and roll it out. So I think that's really important. It's one of the key aspects. Second is this, like, it's probably, you have to be a brand ambassador. you got to walk the walk of the brand. You got to do selling. You got to do the employment branding as well. And I think that's really important because again, you got to lead from the front. So you have to show up. And be positive. And I suppose thirdly would probably be you have to combine the technical aspects with customer journey and the business needs all into one bundle to provide to then come up with meaningful outcomes of projects. I think that is probably one of the key aspects. It's just amalgamation of all those three roles into outcomes because essentially you're the only one in some ways that can piece together the different departments, but also provide the technology solution to move the organization forward. So I think that's one of the key roles that I play here is to help them visualize the art of possible and saying, and just take them along the journey for that. And I suppose at the end of it, you just got to be brave, you know, you got to take the knocks and you just got to keep pushing. I think that's again, really important.
Yeah. And I'm sure many CIOs would empathize with that, going through a lot of knocks, especially in recent times. Yeah. And I loved your perspective there on thinking like a startup, but operating like an enterprise, because, yeah, you are gearing the organization up for the future with your role. So then just reflecting back on what you were saying about also representing the employment brand, you know, people are our biggest assets, and especially in this war for talent that, you know, a lot of CIOs are seeing at the moment, it's more important than ever to make people feel engaged and that they're achieving at work. So how are you creating that internal culture that really helps your people thrive?
Again, as cheesy as it sounds, I think I find shared purpose as being one of the most compelling reasons why a person would want to engage and want to stay. So I think that is by far one of the strongest motivators as I've used in my arsenal to help organizations move forward. Again, it really does depend on organization. Here at Restaurant Brands, I think, you know, coming up with a couple of good initiatives, things like think globally and engage locally, I think it's quite a nice phrase that all is trying to do. So whatever projects you're rolling out, you're not doing it for New Zealand. You have to think about it globally. You know, you're engaging with millions and millions of customers, over hundreds of thousands of transactions. So you have the power to influence their day, from their customers to the team members. So you should feel proud about how you engage and what you do, and take pride that you know, you're helping New Zealand move forward. So I think that's a really important piece around the shared purpose and shared vision is super important, especially for us here in Restaurant Brands.
So another aspect of, you know, high-performing teams is diverse teams. And traditionally, you know, IT roles have not been diverse, have not attracted diverse talent. So what practical things do you think can be done to encourage more people from different backgrounds into IT roles here in New Zealand?
Yeah, that's a big question, and I'm sure you've heard all the usual answers as well. But for me personally, I feel as though it's definitely a grassroots scenario where you have to kind of work with schools. So I'm really big on digital inclusion and things like that. So I think you really have to start at the school level. So there's a lot of wonderful programs people can get involved with, like the Wonder Project, where they teach STEM at school, and I've volunteered as well in one of my local schools down the road. And a lot of it is just working with our kids to show them the art of possible. So again, it's just really saying, dude, I grew up in a school not much like this. And if I can do it, you can do it. And just getting them excited about it. And again, it's not a seminar, it's not a one-time thing. It's over a whole term where we engage them meaningfully across 10 to 12 weeks. And I find as though you have to start at the grids level. It's just how do we then scale that outwards? And I think the Wonder Project is one example of one that you're doing really, really well. And that will then continually drive digital inclusion and digital equity within our organization. I think once you start at the grassroots, everything else will come a bit easier through the journey. And then because it's hard to do it top down, it has to be bottom up in my mind.
And I guess as well, working for somewhere like Restaurant Brands, where it has such well-known brands to, you know, that kids probably will be aware of, helps, I guess, in that conversation about what you do in your role, and them seeing that it's not just the restaurant itself, that there's a whole ecosystem that supports that.
And we help them as well, right? We support them every single day. So our team touches and engages with them every other day to make sure their lives are better. So I think that's also important. And also another way is obviously to encourage diversity of thought. I think that's really important. You know, having quite a flat structure, cross-functional teams, I think that's always quite crucial to ensure we also have diversity of thought in what we do. No one has all the answers.
No, they don't. So, Kenny, when you reflect back on your career, are there any kind of mistakes or things that you did that, you know, when you look back on it, they really shaped you as a leader and they were a great learning experience?
Oh, Yeah, I've done plenty. I suppose if you keep pushing and you keep pushing forward at pace, you undoubtedly will run into issues or missteps. And to be honest, I find those absolutely invaluable because they all just add to the arsenal of knowledge that you have within your tool belt. For me, it's over time. It's about not so much the mistakes, it's about how you recover and how do you kind of like keep trying, because most people give up. And so I think that teaches you the whole kind of grit, the whole resilience piece. So I think a lot of it is how do you quickly recover? How do you mentally then move yourself forward and then take your organization and your people forward as well during a misstep and things like that? So again, just modeling the behavior, I think it's really quite important.
And what's then some of the best career advice you've ever received?
Again, getting back to being quite a meticulous planner, one of the key ones I always have is I always hope for the best, but I plan for the worst. So I think it's always good to have aspirational goals, and it's great to get the team along for that journey because you have to get them motivated and invigorated on the outcome. But you also have to tell them that, well, we've got to plan for the worst, right? So it's not all rainbows and unicorns. You also have to plan for the fallout. And I think that's one of the key things I work through my teams and the people that I mentor. I think that's one of the key things. And the second one is probably, I suppose the greatest gift I can give to you is for you to teach yourself. Again, it's about how do you encourage the lifelong learner? Because, you know, it's just easy just to binge on TV, right? So it's about just how do we then take that next journey? How do we show them this is, no, what you're doing now is not going to pay off in the next 6 months. It's going to pay off over the next 2 to 3 years. And again, that's what I went through with my teams and people I mentor. It's just like, it's not for now. It's for the future. Just like the kids. It's not for now. It's for the future. But we have to start somewhere. That's the way I look at it.
Absolutely. And finally, Kenny, what's important to you in the months ahead?
The months ahead, I suppose over the next 6 months for us, it's going to be a lot of rationalization. And I think that's the part around, being super cheesy, it's going to be like you have to do more with less. So I'm challenging my teams to work smarter, not harder. And now's the perfect time. It's absolutely the perfect time to do it because come 2023, it's going to open up again and volumes are going to return, right? So for us, it's about just get smarter, clean your house, tidy up or whatever you need to do, and keep pushing forward. I think that's a really, really, really important aspect now. It's just to keep your head up and keep moving forward, you know, encourage people.
Great. Exciting times ahead and no doubt a busy time as we head into 2023. Kenny Fine, CIO at Restaurant Brands, thank you so much for your time today.